Have you ever heard of a town called Manteo on Roanoke Island in North Carolina? The Lost Colony.
Yeah. Good play. It's been going on every summer for 50-some years.
This is where the first English colony lived?
On Roanoke Island.
And no one knows what happened to them?
Mm-mm. Nope. You know, the old-timers say that on a full moon, a pure white doe can be seen out on the sand dunes. They say that's the spirit of Virginia Dare.
Gives you the chills, doesn't it?
Mr. Matlock.
Yeah?
You're supposed to go straight to the courthouse, sir. They sent a cab.
I've been in elevators bigger than that. The thing bounced like a jackrabbit all the way from Raleigh.
Oh, well, at least you're in good hands. Chris there is the most experienced pilot we've got.
Well, sure.
You have a good stay.
Hey, Troy!
Are you him?
Him who?
We heard about your suit.
Well, I'm a lawyer.
Is that it?
Well, it's my suit. Excuse me.
That's him. What do you think?
Well, I know.
You paid Jack Rose to lie.
Nuts, mister.
What the hell are you talking about?
Which one of you killed Ryan? Or was it all of you?
Spencer, get away from the car. Get away from the car. Spencer!
Murderers! I never heard of Roanoke Island before. And the only reason I'm down here now, during the course of this trial, I'm talking real dumb. Forget the hot temper part. You got that?
Yeah.
Who's Conrad McMasters?
Me.
Conrad broke up a fight between Ryan Bartell.
Ryan Bartell lives on the Mother Vineyard Road.
Why don't you give Mr. Matlock a ride?
All right. My first name's Ben.
Conrad.
Ben and Conrad.
Conrad?
Yeah. And there's the library. Yep. That's Gordon Kellogg's supply.
Oh, that's a nice looking store. Sell lumber. What else they sell?
Whatever you need.
Oh, nice.
And there's your basic house.
Uh-huh.
And then, as you can see, woods.
Yeah. You like it here, huh?
Yeah. Yeah. Pretty much all I know. I've traveled. I mean, I've been to New York, Miami.
Atlanta?
Been to Atlanta.
Uh-huh.
But I always wind up back here.
Well, you like it here? You like your job?
Yeah. I think I'm ahead of the game.
Oh, well, sure.
Okay, here we are.
Uh-huh.
Boy, that's nice. Big.
Sure doesn't look like timeshare.
Oh, timeshare.
Do they come in here a lot?
A lot. Have a couple beers, then either eat dinner here or go to one of their houses to play poker and have pizzas delivered.
They play poker a lot?
Well, they like to gamble a little, I guess.
Uh-huh. Huh.
What?
This is a peculiar bunch of duck hunters. They play poker all night, eat pizza. What happens to the duck they shoot? Don't they eat them?
Central Dispatch to McMaster's, can you copy?
Go ahead, Clarence. Go ahead, Clarence. What?
Get over to Jack Rose's garage. Spencer Hamilton's there and is trying to beat the living hell out of Jack.
Not gonna hurt you. Jack!
Uh-huh. See that?
Trying to make you tell me why you lied.
I'm gonna press charges, pal.
Mr. Rose.
Come on, Jeff. Come on.
Now, I told you.
You're on trial for murder. You can't go around here acting like some kind of jackass.
Hi. Mr. D'Amato?
Spaghetti sauce.
I'm Ben Matlock, Spencer Hamilton's lawyer.
He's a bum. He shot Ryan Bartell in cold blood.
All right.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Oh, well.
Oh. Is there something I can do for you?
Oh, hi. I'm Ben Matlock, Spencer Hamilton's lawyer. That's a nice boat.
I like it.
I heard you always drive that sports car when you're down here.
He sold his other car to me. I buy all my cars from my friends. That way I know what I'm getting.
What a good idea. Ben Matlock, Spencer Hamilton's lawyer. You must be Lee Kramer.
Get your gun, David. Let's go shoot some targets.
Now, how about me? I mean, you got your headset. You can listen to some Mozart or the Grateful Dead or something, but I'm not doing anything, so what do you say?
Okay.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
So you and David both stockbrokers?
Hell no, I'm an oil leaser.
Oh, Dallas, Denver, Houston?
Houston.
Oh. That's an easy way to lose your shirt, especially these days.
Awful lot of bad luck going around.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh!
There you go.
Oh, well.
I ain't never seen nothing like it. Them big blues got them schools of trout. and run them up on the beach, and I picked up two or three buckets full myself.
When was that?
Yesterday. I always miss it. Never fail. I get there the day before it or the day after. It just kills my soul. Wouldn't you think a person just one time could get there the day of it?
Happens to me, too. Boys, and that's what brought the people down here. The fish, water, beaches, sun, lost colony play. But in the 50s, that's just fine. But now, we just got too many of them.
Tell them, Commissioner.
Wintertime. Good for the economy. Let people know where this place is at. Good all around.
You campaigning again, Commissioner?
Boy, there's a lot of people down here.
Summertime, they come from all over.
Well, I don't blame them. It's pretty down here. Have you been here all your life?
Like the fella says, not yet.
Oh. What do you think?
Great, I'm past it.
You remember?
Fondly.
Sheriff, those hunting fellas, how did they get to be friends? I mean, one's from Houston, one's from Boston, one's from Chicago. I mean, they're from all over.
Well, the story is they met on vacation, liked one another, and they started meeting at different places and taking a little trip together and wound up here.
Huh. Wound up here.
Sheriff, it's Matlock.
Well, hello, Commissioner.
Oh, look, what they say about you is true. You are everywhere.
I like to keep up. But you're the one that's everywhere, isn't he, Sheriff?
He's a little young yet. See you later, boy.
I see you, Sheriff.
I heard you was over here. You making any progress on your case?
Oh, I asked you a few questions around. So, county commissioner, huh?
Oh, no. I've run for commissioner a lot of times.
Never won?
Never did. Pretty soon, folks just started calling me commissioner.
Oh, ex officio, huh?
Yeah, hell, I like a good joke.
Yeah.
In the meantime, I got my little practice, insurance business, one-third interest in a used car lot.
Huh.
So you're making some progress on that case,
well,
huh?
Well, yeah. Moderate, yeah. Ben Matlock. Who is it? Elizabethan Gardens. But I guess so, but... What's going on?
I got a call. Anonymous, the person fitting your description was seen buying or accepting a substance at Whalebone Junction on the beach. And they said this car was here, too.
You don't think I got dope in my car?
What is that?
Cocaine.
What the hell is cocaine doing? Well, surely you... Surely you don't... How the hell could you drag me in?
No, I had no choice. You were carrying.
Mr. Matlock, I will have order.
Your Honor, I was framed.
Mr. Matlock, you're out of turn. In my court, we follow procedure.
I understand.
Mr. Matlock, one more outburst like that, and I'll charge you with contempt.
Tell the truth. You don't take dope.
No, I don't take dope.
How is this going to affect the case?
Now, listen. I came down here for one reason. To defend the man that I believe is innocent. And if you think I'll jeopardize my chances by smoking cocaine or whatever the hell else you do with it, then you got another thing. And I'll tell you something else. Just because you come from a small town doesn't give you the right. And I'm telling you something. What?
Wait, Mr. Matlock,
But you got a call
then
now.
You got a... But I was framed.
I believe you.
Oh, well.
And somebody planted that cocaine because you're getting close to something.
Well, that's right.
Boy, that was good.
Yeah, you were just hungry.
Yeah. These for show?
I mess around a little bit now and then. Okay. Let's see. Yeah. I got one.
When it's peach picking time in Georgia, apple picking time in Tennessee, cotton picking time in Mississippi, everybody picks on me. When it's roundup time in Texas, the cow won't make whoopee. Way down south in Alabama, it's cow picking time to me.
I gotta tell you something. This day wound up a lot better than it started.
Yeah.
Two eggs.
You feel calm.
Oh, yeah, calm. Yeah.
All right. Which one of you friends?
Or was it all of you?
Man's crazy.
What are you talking about?
I came to Manteo to defend a client. That's business. But whoever framed me just made it personal.
Got nothing to do with us, Ben.
You're a liar.
Hold on. You've got no reason to make such an accusation.
You lied about everything.
One more time.
Yes, sir.
Having a bad day? Happens to the best of us.
You have got to be new in town. Because if I'd seen you before, I'd remember.
Just drove in this morning from Richmond. Beautiful.
Sure is.
How about a walk on the beach?
Yeah. Oh, expecting a phone call.
Ben Matlock, hey.
Yeah.
Ben. Yeah. I got something to tell you that's going to knock your head off.
What?
Well, I got me an idea, and I just had to follow through on it.
What?
Well, you know, the money for Jack Rose's garage was put up by Lee Kramer, David Channing, Ernie D'Amato, and the late Frank Hamilton and Ryan Bartell.
Thank you very much.
It's in Matlock.
Oh, sure, I remember. And then, well, yes, sir. I'd be glad to do that.
Hey.
Hi, Miss Yelston.
Hi.
You didn't have any trouble?
No. Yes. Hey, my little evening with David paid off. I have something.
All right.
He travels a lot. Europe, South America, the Bahamas.
Sorry, I'm late. Oh, sit down, Conrad. Conrad McMaster, Michelle Thomas, my associate.
How are you? Good. Just talked to the Boston police.
The lost cop.
Gives you the chills, doesn't it?
What's going on? What's this all about?
We believe your brother and Ryan Bartell and the others were running drugs.
David arranged a meeting with someone for 2:00 today at Beggs Bay. I didn't hear everything, but I did hear him say, make it a twin if you can.
Let's see what you got.
It's almost 2. Where the hell are they?
If the plane shows, they'll show.
There's something. That's it.
Clarence, everybody keep down. Sit tight.
Why didn't they show Conrad?
Well, at least we got the drugs.
Take up there in the back.
We don't have diddly.
What?
Diddly.
Conrad.
Rip everything out of there. Rip out the seat cushions, pontoon storage. Move! Come on.
There's nothing in there, Conrad.
There's gotta be something in there.
Diddly.
I'll see you back at the office.
Hey, fella. I want to talk to you.
Sign it, David.
free.
Put it alongside.
Just toss these right in.
Everybody freeze! All right, all you hit the deck, come on. Hands in plain sight. Move, come on!
Come on, let's go.
Okay, clear.
Well, I gotta hand it to you, Conrad. You were right. What's the charge?
Conspiracy to deliver a controlled substance, maybe?
Try tax evasion. They weren't smuggling drugs in, they were smuggling drug money out. I've got a pocket knife. We'll split your pants up about that far. There's no scar. You're home free. We'll get you a new pair of pants. What's that?
I have got a little scar from when I was working on the propeller of my boat.
Nothing further.
We find the defendant, Spencer Hamilton, not guilty.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. This court is adjourned.
Okay, say, now this is important. Don't touch this. This is a flash. Look for this little square box here. And then what time would you do
this? Oh, what a nice looking group here. Thanks.
Well, Mr. Matlock, yeah. Thanks for everything.
Good luck. Good luck to you.
Thanks,
Conrad.
Thank you.
Me first.
Yeah,
bass knife.
Conrad, I'm glad to have met you.
So am I glad to have met you.
This is Jimmy. Jimmy's a bass knife.
Good, huh?
Yeah.
Especially
when Bobby.
Winning tastes good, doesn't it?
Bobby's a nose, but he married bass knife.
Next time you come, we'll keep it a secret. I'll take you bluefish.
This is Betty Alice Mayer.
Bluefish, listen. If you come to Atlanta, I know.
This is John Wilson. He's a cousin, but hell, everybody on the island's a cousin.
You come to Atlanta, I know a place where there's catfish. You can't catch any, but you can buy all you want.
Yeah, this is Mama. Yeah.
Smile.
Oh.